Saturday. Usually I stream on a Friday, so happy Saturday. It is a gloomy day here in BC, but it's all good. The plants and everything are getting water, so we are going to make, I don't have a sample yet because I didn't want to get ahead of myself. We are going to make ephemera for our journals or cards or junk journals or whatever it is you like to create and put ephemera in. Hello, Exora. How are you today? So I have, as I told you to prep if you were going to play along, I have some tea bags that are dried out and emptied. Thank you. And I actually did a coffee filter too because I figured someone would ask, and it is thicker, but we will test it out because I figured someone would probably ask. So I have some of those prepped. I grabbed a Ziploc bag and I've cut it along the side and the bottom. So it's all, it's a big piece. So this is what I will be using on top of my desk as the base to glue the little pieces to. Oh, the little bits of tea stuck on it. Oh well. I have my matte medium, which will dry clear. I have my archival ink pad. Hello, Jen. Happy Saturday. Happy October 29th. It's almost Halloween. It's almost Halloween. Okay, so you can grab tissue paper. You can grab fancy napkins. You can grab... See, my voice always goes. I have some deli paper that I've pre-stamped with some of my Paper Artsy stamps. I used ones from my latest release, as well as I grabbed some from my Christmas release from last year. I don't think I grabbed Halloween. No, but we've got some good ones here. And then, of course, my next release is November 21st, so mark it on your calendars. That will be a live release on the Paper Artsy page as well as where you're watching me right now. Are you ready to get to it? And we can do a little commercial later if you guys want to see the planners, because my hard copy did arrive, so I can show you what that looks like. I have the soft cover and the hard cover. I'm going to just move my keyboard out of the way here, so you don't need to see that. I'm going to flip you down. Are you ready? Do, 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 do. A three, a two, and a one. Ta-da! Okay, I kept my desktop rather messy because I wanted to show that you can use a bunch of different art supplies as you're playing. You're not that limited. So I have, these are done on deli paper. On one of them here, I did paint the back of it with some Paper Artsy fresco finish aqua duck egg paint, just so we can see what it looks like if you pre-paint the back of one. And then I have a bunch of the deli paper, which I actually showed you last week as well, from my stamp sets. If you're curious about what stamp set they're from, because you'd like to get them, I can easily show you and tell you the number. But I've got the martinis, I've got our angel girl, Christmas trees. I know, it's Halloween weekend, I know. Our nutcracker. Gladys, hello. Meryl, thank you for liking the stream. And then I have some blank ones too that we can play with. As well as I grabbed some of the actual Paper Artsy tissue paper that they sell, or if you order anything directly from them, they actually wrap your supplies in these tissue papers. So you get some when you order any kind of supplies, and then you can use them for creating. Like, is this the first one? Nope, this is, I believe this is the second release of the tissue paper. Yes, it is. Okay, so we have that. It's my kind of embossing sheet. Cans. With, if you want to watercolor or color your pieces before you turn them into the ephemera, you can do that. I haven't tried it on the tissue paper. As we know, when tissue paper gets wet, it rips easy, and that's how you can get your little pieces and all that. That is why I kind of chose the deli paper. I figured I could color a few of those to try and show you. So we know that we're going to do this one. To live a creative life, we must lose our fear of being wrong. I might be one of him. Definitely going to do some of the typewriter keys. I think a teacup would look awesome, personally. A little teacup. Then there's my Rococo girl that actually kind of looks like RuPaul to me in the end. I was not trying to do RuPaul, but that's just who it looks like to me. Squid ink, I think that would look phenomenal as a piece. We have Creeping It Real at Christmas. Here I have some of the snowflakes with little skulls and hearts in them. Some of the holly. We have the martini and the angelic wishes and goth girl kisses. And there's our little punk rock angel. Here is our punk rock gothic Christmas tree. It's got little skulls and candy canes on it. And I believe, what song did I put on there? I think I did Silent Night. I'd have to get out my magnifying glass. And Sir Nutcracker. So, before we start, I'll just quickly show you the stamp sets, so in case you had any questions. Okay, let's pull. I actually didn't do any of the dolls. I should have done some of the dolls. I couldn't do everything though, right? But okay, let's pull down in sets. I'm missing. I don't have one of the Christmas ones here. I must be using in the other room. So there's this one, which is ENB05. So cute. This was my second release. ENB04. And the one with the nutcracker should be ENB06. Oh no, it is here. It is. It's hiding. ENB06. And there's the ornaments too. They'd be fun. Halloween. So this one's the first one. I didn't do the cat. The cat would be really cool too. This is ENB01 and the bones. ENB02. So if you wanted to do Halloweeny ones, those would be super fun. Especially all grungy. I have a bad connection, so we'll reboot and come back. Fingers crossed, Gladys. And then this is ENB03. Super cute. Then, is this 10, 11, 12? Yes. So, ENB010. No, ENB10. Getting ahead of myself. ENB11. Even to do some of these border pieces would be really cool with the tea bags, right? And you can have a whole piece going across your page or your card. There's the typewriter keys. This is ENB12. Okay. So these are the ones that I have used to stamp on the pages. I didn't use a Halloween, but I know it's Halloweeny weekend, so I thought I'd show you those too. And then, of course, there's my articulated girl set, too, where you can make some moving girls. Those are fun. Okay. Let us grab. I think we should do some of this. So I'm just going to rough tear it because it does kind of rip when it gets wet like tissue, but not exactly the same as tissue will. Move these over. We're going to use this one first. And this one I'm not going to pre-paint. So we'll do some in different ways so you can see the kind of difference in them all. Let's see. Let's kind of It helps a bit on the deli paper, but not at all like the tissue paper when it goes to ripping. I just kind of want to do an abstract kind of shape. I am thinking about the size of the tea bags as well, right? See, this side I'll like get more wet before I tore it, so it's helping. So that's our keys. So the tea bags, I cut just down one side and emptied them. I have not cut down the others. I say that now as I'm like, where's my scissors? I'm going to rip them because I don't want them to look straight. So I'm just going to pull them apart. There's still a little bit of tea in some of these. Not too much. I'll just shake that over here. And this is another one too. If you want to have it looking rough, you can go ahead and just kind of rough tear the edges, because it's to look vintage and worn, right? And you definitely remember want a plasticky surface to put it on that you can easily peel it off of. So be it like a Ziploc bag, or save the bags inside your cereal box when you're done eating your cereal. I wouldn't suggest wax paper because I think that would stick too much. Let's see, just seeing if it's a good fit. It sticks out a bit on the side. I'm just going to make this one a little thinner. I can save this bit for something else. Some collage. Okay. So let's move these over because I'm going to start over here and kind of work across, because I like keeping this space clear for working and coloring and such. So I'm going to put down a little acrylic matte medium. You can use Mod Podge or other things like that as well. It got me on my wrist. Make sure the tea is stuck on the other side. So we're putting down some first. We're going to grab the deli paper and get that down there, because this kind of gives it like the coating. You can even use school glue, believe it or not. That white school glue that dries clear. I'm going to take our tea bag. Why is my hand shaky today? I have no idea. I was thinking too, even if you wanted to add some more colors to these, you could grab some like infusions or even your sprays, because mine didn't get too stained. This one's better. This one got really stained. It depends on the type of teas too. So I'm going in and I'm pushing in the edges just so it looks a little more kind of beat up and crinkly, and then it'll be easier to pick up as well once it's dry. And it's kind of cool to have a few wrinkles, show some character, right? And then flatten it down again, because you don't want it too lumpy, right, for when you're going to use it. So that's that one without any paint on it. And then when it's dry, we will peel it up and take a look at it. Let us grab, to do the tree or that, I need a long one, but I don't have a long one. I was trying to go through all my tea bags yesterday. My husband came in, and I'm a tea drinker, and so I had like all these tea boxes all over the kitchen counter, and I was pulling them out and comparing what kind of bags, because there are some that are different. Where's that one? Which won't work, but it's hiding because it knows it won't work. It's kind of a plastic mesh. Where did it go? It totally is hiding. It was in here. When I first pulled them out to show you, it was there. Oh, there it is. I couldn't even see it. Yeah, it's like a mesh. It's very plasticky. I don't know. It could work. It could be kind of cool. But I think then you'd want to add some color to your deli paper piece. Look at this. I took out. So just so you know, I'm busy making all my samples for the next release for Paper Artsy, which is November 21st. And so a lot of my supplies are in the other room because I'm doing it out there, because I can't risk anything being seen when I go live on the computer. So, well, it's a good thing I don't really need scissors today. Okay, so I don't have one big enough for the tree, but we can layer them together too, actually. We could. Do we want to do the tree, or do we want to do, like, the martini, or the girl, the martini? I know I'm going to do the ink one, so let's do this ink one first. Because then we can put some color on it and then put it away so it dries, or even use a heat gun so it dries. I'm going to use these paints today. I don't use these much. These are sample. These are, so they're beam paints, and I don't have many of them, but I bought their imperfects. Every so often they have an imperfect sale, which means either they've like doubled the color. They put two of one color in the palette, so they can't sell that for full price, or it's coming apart like this one is from the birch tree. And so, yeah, you get it at a discount. So I thought that was a great way of trying their paints. So I'm going to do that. Let's spritz it with some water. You could use your inks as well if you have some inks that don't react again to the water, because you don't want to do like paint something pretty in pink with like this, or with my Ferris wheel inks, and then just have it reactivate and move right across. You kind of want what you do to stay in place. I am going to do our little octopus dude in this aqua. I'll do this one at the edge. So it's just to give a bit of color. We don't have to go fully into detail. But we want to have some distinction. I say dude, but it's an octopus lady. With her beautiful lips and eyelashes. Our feminine octo. Actually, she's not an octo, she's a squid. Because it's squid ink. Where can I balance the color on the label? Organic squid ink. I wonder if you can use squid ink for like calligraphy. Would that work? I don't know. That would be interesting to try. I don't have. I was thinking I wanted like a bright red for the lips, but I don't have one here. some metallics on here. These are something too, you can go ahead and do all your little watercolor paintings or use your pencils and color pieces in. Kind of do it like an assembly. You do all these pieces and then come and do all of these with like the tea bags and such. Kind of like how I got my tea bags ready last night. It didn't take long for them to dry. I laid them out, or I let them soak in a mug for a couple of hours, and then I took them out, squeezed whatever I could of the liquid out of them, and then I laid them on a few layers of paper towel. Ooh, we could give her gold lips. Metallic lips. She's fabulous. We need some eyeshadow that's metallic then too. Oh, that one's bleeding out. It was still wet. And then oh, I know what I'll do for ink. Okay, I'm just gonna dry this and then I'm gonna grab a fluid golden paint. This one's really dark, an indigo. I'm going to use this for the ink in the bottle, just because it kind of mimics a nice dark ink. A little bit of water on here, just to help it move around. And this is very potent, so I don't need much. When I say potent, I mean like high pigment. That in her eye. You could get in there and do a whole bunch of shading too on your stamped images, but I don't know yet. I haven't experimented enough yet to see how well it will show through the tea bag. So on this one, I'm just going to leave it as it is and not do shading. Or should I? Okay, I'm gonna dry it and we're gonna use pencils. Sorry, this is the way I work. It's like, ooh, let's try that, let's try that. That's how she is with the watercolors and the golden fluid. High flow, not fluid, high flow. High flow! Pencils. Let's just grab some prismas or something. What's this one? Again, this is something you wouldn't do on the tissue because the pencils would probably... Oh, this is a pastel. This is a... Can't read it. This feels like a chalk pastel kind of pencil. It's not a waxy one. I'll just do a wee bit. Just a wee bit. Just a touch. Sorted better than that, but I guess not. Let's grab. I just want to make the word ink stand out more. There we go. Just a wee bit of pencil work. There's a squirrel above my room. You can hear it. For this one, well, that one will work if I open it long ways. Long ways. I have other videos from the past from when I was working on the Art Adventures with Alice art tutorial book, and it's using teas to paint with, and we actually use different teas. So there's like black teas. I think there was a blueberry tea. There was all different ones, and so. It was interesting that in the beginning, when you paint with them, they have different colors. And then, as they dried over time, they became closer to being the same. Like they lost kind of like their pinkness and stuff. Sorry, I'm trying to rip it without making a big mess on my desk. There's still some tea hiding in the corners of the tea bag. And this one is ripped, but in the center. But I think that'll look pretty cool. Plus, we can add layers over top if we want. But there's lots of nice texture, like right in there. Just getting rid of some of those straight edges. Okay. Yeah, let the water sink in a bit to the deli paper so it's ripping better now. Some more medium. Let's test that one. Let's put our squid ink down. I don't want to brush it too much because I don't want to reactivate that. The watercolors there. And I'm going to take our tea bag. This one, maybe I will sprinkle a bit of the infusions on, just so you can. Do I want to do it on this one or the next one? Let's do it on the next one. Let's try and keep some separate examples. Okay, I'm gonna rough up the edges a bit here, push it in so it's easy to peel off later. Flatten them down as well. And just so you know, I did learn this technique from a video on YouTube as well. I can't think of who it was though, but I thought that is the coolest and I want to try that and share it with you guys. So this next one, I'm going to use a piece of the paper artsy tissue. So that way we don't have to, you don't have to watch me color something as much. Let's see, which image should we use? So again, this is something that if you buy products directly from Paper Artsy, you'll get it in your, you'll get your products wrapped in it, as well as you can buy packages of it from your local Paper Artsy supplier. Kind of like the numbers there. The numbers are kind of cool. You don't have to do them all though. With a butterfly? Should we do a butterfly? Let's do a butterfly. I knocked the tea bag down. So you'll see the difference on how easy this is to rip out when it's wet. And you get way more jagged edges. It's really cool. So I'm barely touching it, but I want to make sure I get a full butterfly. So I'm kind of hanging on and guiding the rip a wee bit. Grab this wing and pull it. There we go. There's our butterfly. Pretty butterfly. That one I'm going to sprinkle. Let's give it a different color. Do some blue infusions. Let's get some blue in there. Sometimes it's hard to tell how, I think I got quite a bit of color on there. It's hard to tell sometimes because you can't really see the little speckles. Oh, they're starting to activate now. And then we'll put a tea bag over top. Just ripping them down the sides. You kind of want to do where the seams are to do your rips, because then you get that nice piece in the center. And this one, I don't think I'm going to tear apart. I'm just going to put it down the way it is without doing the edges, and then we'll push in the edges instead of tearing them. Get some wrinkles in there. be conscious of your brush bristles too as you do this, because you don't want to wreck your paintbrushes. Okay, three down. Three down! Let us do... What should we do? You know what would be interesting? I want to do it the opposite way. I want to do the teabag first, and then the image on top, and see how our layers, how they look different, like how much more the lines stand out in that. So I'm gonna grab our girl. Let's grab her. Let's do her. Tea. Bits of tea. My hair isn't long enough to tuck behind my ear anymore. We have to do that quote too that I did the blue behind. So we have two tea bags and we have the coffee filter. Okay. Do I want to paint her? Let's paint her in behind. Let's give her candy floss. So these are fresco finish paints, not watercolors. Let's do her roses pink. So she has roses in her hair. She has a bat in her hair. She has a big rose ring. Let's give her some color on her cheeks. I'm used to seeing it the other way, so I'm like, where's the roses? Where's the bat? It's good when you're trying something new like this to actually go in and fully experiment. She has little rose earrings as well. As we're doing it with different ways. I'm not going to do her skin. I just want to do her hair, her dress, and probably her eyes. So I'm going to put some white in her eyes. Because we don't want them to look all brown. Yellow bodice, yellow submarine, or let's do tangerine twist. I can actually do both because she has all those like Rococo style designs on her dress. Granny Smith apple. And just paint it on thin because you don't want it to take forever to dry. Oh, I missed a rose on her collar. That's okay. I'm not being precise at all. Just choosing which areas and then doing the same areas on the other side. Pardon me. Okay, and then thistle. Do we want thistle or moonlight in the hair? Let's do thistle. So we'll do all the curls except where our little bat is. Go around the flowers. Into her eyes. Her eyes. Hello. Purple eyes. Internet out. Oh no. Zora. Look how cool that looks when you paint in behind on the deli paper. So even if you weren't going to use it for this technique, that's pretty wild. It's pretty wild. I like it. Oh, I put the bottles right on top of our butterfly. Look at that. I didn't even see it. This one's starting to get dry. I can feel it. Yeah, the tissue paper definitely rips a lot easier, but with the deli paper, like I said, you can paint it, you can color it with pencils. If you wanted this girl to have tattoos, you can do little designs on her too before you attach her. You could even use some of the other tissue paper that's already printed and cut out little pieces to give her like a tattoo. Just gonna try and rip it a little closer. Should we put her on top of the coffee filter, do you think, or the tea bag? You might see more of the edges on top of the coffee filter. I am ripping in right into her edges just because I don't want to see all the edge of the deli paper. Tissue paper disappears more than deli paper does, like the edging of it. And since we're going to do this one on top, we want to lose as much of that as we can. This one still has some tea in it too. It's funny how some tea bags shred easier than others. This one's kind of shredding on me. Like that other one did for the ink bottle. They're not items that are meant to last, right? They're meant to break down in that, so they're not that sturdy. Just gonna rough up the edges. We do not want it to look perfect. I think that's pretty good. She will hang over a wee bit. Maybe, maybe, maybe not. I think she will. I think her shoulder will. Okay. Number four. Let's do a combo. Let's do a combo. I'm gonna do a coffee and tea bag. Get it nice and thin underneath. Put this down. Get our tea bag and this. A little too wrinkly in the center. Okay, that's a good base now for her. Right, and we'll take our madam, I'm pounding the painted side down. Okay. So see how these edges are not going away? You can still see them, but maybe we could push those in too. Let's try it. All we can do is try things. Try, try, try. That's better. That one was just a little too big at the edge. And then I'm going to push in these edges. And then flatten them down. There we go. So she is on top. So if you want your image to stand out even more, that's pretty cool. Let's do one more. I don't know if we'll use this one because it's like plastic. We could. I guess we should experiment with everything, right? Is that how you're going to rip? Nope, the seam's on the bottom. Okay. Yeah, that's that plasticky mesh one. Okay, so let us do. Should we do? Oh, let's do that one. I painted the back of it. Where is it? Where is it? This one. We have to do this one. Just wondering if we should use a coffee filter again or not. Let's get this nice and damp and then let it rest so I can rip it easy. So this one has the paint on the back again. The fresco finish aqua duck egg. Take that one and then symbolically, maybe we should be doing a teacup, hey? For the last one. So these will be our last two, and then we will dry these and see if we can peel up. You're back, Dora! Yay! Whoa. Okay, to live a creative life, we must lose our fear of being wrong. And our teacup. kind of like, I don't know, I like them both, with color and without. All these choices. So this one. Okay, we have one tea bag that's like this. So, choices, choices. We have to make choices. Those corners just don't want to rip. See what we can do here. Some of the excess. From now on, I plan to save almost all my tea bags when I have a cup of tea because I think it would be fabulous to have a whole bunch of this ephemera that's just kind of ready to go for when you're journaling and even traveling because they don't take up much room. It would be neat for when you go and do some art in a cafe or something and you can grab like the teacup one or a girl one or if you had some that were like Eiffel Towers and you were in France or something and put those straight into your book. Or cards to send home if you're a card maker. Make up a little card there and then send it on home to your loved ones. My dog is at my studio door. She wants to come in. Push in the edges. And again, remember, it's not just aesthetics as to why we push in and flatten the edges. It's to help you be able to peel it off the plastic after it's dry. There's that one. And this one, I think I'm going to put, I'm thinking I'm doing coffee filter in behind. Are we going to put this over anything? We should try something, shouldn't we? We'll think about that. Let's think about that. If you have an idea, put it in the comments. So I always kind of like pinch below and above as to where I don't want the rip to go, and then I know it's going to kind of rip along that edge. So that's one way of keeping it from ripping your actual image that you're working with. No, I don't think I need to. Let's see. Not pressing it down yet. I think that'll cover. It won't give us much extra space on the outside. And then let's do the coffee filter. Let's go for it. We need to experiment. We're here to experiment. The name of the game is Experiment and Create Fun Ephemera. Coffee filter. So the coffee filters we use are the unbleached bamboo ones, in case you were wondering what type of coffee filter. Let's get this back up and put it over here. I'm gonna put this on top. Some coffee grounds on it. Or tea grounds, tea leaves. There's a few on my desk. And go the edges. Almost ready. Ooh. Are you ready? Are you ready? I think we can peel this one up. So you need to get an edge and work it. You don't want to rip it because remember there's like the medium all around it. Oh. I think it needs a little more time. Oh no. Carefully. It was separating a bit, but I fixed it. So look at that. It's very shiny on the back from the putting on the plastic and that. But you could do that and you can spray things too. I am going to, just to show you. Let's get some distress spray. Stain. I'm just going to put some around here. I'm going to spray it as well with the water. So I don't want the ink spray going everywhere. I would even. Where's my coffee? I usually have a bottle with aged coffee in it. Where are you, my friend? It's hiding. Watch, after it'll be like right in my face as to where it is. I don't see it. I usually have it handy lots of times. And it's just, it's black coffee with nothing in it. Oh, it's spreading out on its own. And I use it to paint with. Must be in the other room. This one, I want to grab Seth Apter's dye spray. I'm going to put it on our butterfly. Ooh. I like that. I like it. Maybe I should try spraying this. You're like, yes, do it. I think it needs a balance. Dab off some excess. want to be able to see our words. Oh, I like it. I like it a lot. Okay. This is on plastic, but I'm going to gently use my heat gun and see if we can peel off the others as well. So it's on the low setting. When it comes to plastic, you don't want to do it too much. This might not be ready, but I'm going to try this one. Just carefully, slowly do it. It's probably best to like leave them overnight. But because we're doing it live, I'm trying to speed it up for you. So there's our ink bottle. And then it is still damp on the back. But when these are totally dry, just like you can go in with your pencils, your paint pens, your markers, whatever. Like I want to do some squiggles and stuff outside of her and do some texture marking on the different ones. She's still damp underneath too, so we still need some more drying time. I'm just going to turn them over and let them dry on the back for a second. Actually, I'll use the heat gun on the back. I like how that turned out. Not quite. Oh yeah, this one's tissue, so that's going to take longer. So let's dry. Doesn't want to seal too much. Too much dried medium. I want to get that off because I don't want any more to dry out on me. There we go. I'm going to dry the back of these so I can do some doodles on top. boy on this. I want a scribbly kind of pen. I want. Okay. So with her, I want just like scribbles. You can write words like love, this scribbly form. Some hearts. I tend to like bright colors. I am doing me. You can always do whatever makes you happy. So I'm doing some fluorescent pink and then maybe some darker edges. Grunge it up a bit. You don't have to. If you're a fan of this, you can just go in and do browns and such. Let's see what else we can grab here. We can grab some gold. Some gold ink. And there's a fine brush. Like here we could go over some of the scrolls or make our own little scrolls on top. I want to grab a Neo Color 2. Either that or a Derwent Ink Test would work as well. So I'm just going to scribble along the edge of our girl here. I'm also going to do it right where her shadow would be. You can darken up her exterior as much as you want. You can even grab one of those pencils that works on glass and all that to really darken things up. Remember, we put her on the top. That's why she stands out more. And I only added a little bit of gold to this one. Other people that I've seen do this pretty much leave it all like this, and then you have a full collection and you can use it on any color page. But I just wanted to show you the different ways you can do things. These ones are not quite ready. They need to stay a little longer. So I hope you guys are inspired. I hope you go play. I would love to see some of the ephemera you create. Thank you so much for joining me. I will post these on Instagram once they're totally done. And again, My little commercial at the end. I just wanted to show you guys, in case you're planner people, my goodies. Sorry. This, of course, is Create Your Own Wonderland. This is not a planner, but it's a book you can paint in. You can cut the pages, color them with whatever you like. There are test pages at the back, so you can test out your products before you commit them to a page. Pardon me. These are the planners that were just launched on Amazon. There's two cover options. Either just the Halloween damask. It's not totally Halloween. There's unicorns in here, pumpkins, skulls, our little creature here, spiders, hearts, all that goodness. Sorry. The soft cover, like this one, and this one, this is the other cover option. They are $12.95 US. And again, I did cream pages inside. I chose that for a reason. So it's a year-long planner, undated. You can start it whenever you want. You can start your weeks on either Mondays or Sundays, your preference. And there's also swatch pages at the back to test out your products before you commit them to a page, so you know if you want to seal your page first. There's ephemera pages where you can cut out pieces and put them on other pages. Okay. So there's a soft cover, $12.95 US. And there's the hardcover option, comes in both covers as well, and I believe it's $19.95 US, and the pages are exactly the same inside. It's just because of the different covers, they're a wee bit difference in size. They're almost the same, they're just a wee bit different. A little taller, a little wider. So on Amazon, you just Google or search my name, Nikki Batalana, N-I-C-C-I. And the book I'm working on next year, for release next year, it doesn't have a title yet, but it's going to be all about art journaling. What is art journaling? And how far can you take it? All that kind of fun stuff. But yeah, so this coming Thursday night is my last market of the year at... It's called Raw. It's Roots and Wings. It's a sip in the shop in Langley. You can find details by messaging me. I will put it on Instagram. And yeah, the last product launch of the year is November 21st. Hello, Lorraine! So I hope you guys mark that in your calendars and come watch the live and see what the new release is all about. So take good care of yourselves. Thank you for joining me today. I hope I inspired you. I'd love to see what ephemera you create. And this will be rewatchable next week on my Teachable site for free. I'm going to be taking it off YouTube and that, and it's going to go to my Teachable site. So you can just watch it there anytime. Okay. So have a great week. Take good care of yourselves. Do your minimum 15-minute kitchen dancing and groove to your favorite songs. Fill your buckets, stay healthy, stay happy, and like and share this video if you had fun, and invite your friends to watch the next live next Thursday. See you soon, guys. Where's my exit? There it is. Bye-bye for now. Bye, guys. See you later.